Recently, Monolith revealed that microtransactions will be in Shadow of War. It's a topic of controversy, but we still wanted to cover it. Today, we'll talk about the in-game economy, the market, and microtransactions in Shadow of War. We'll go over the currencies, how much they're worth, and what you can buy with it. We won't go in depth on the political side of things, if you want to call it that, but just the objective part. Moving on to the in-game economy. As you probably have all found out, you can earn a certain form of currency and buy things with it. We'll quickly go over the two types of currency, how to earn it, and what you can spend the currency on, and of course the loot boxes. The primary form of currency is Mirian. Similar to Shadow of Mordor, it's a silver coin that can only be unlocked through in-game achievements. You can earn it by completing missions of any kind, defeating treasure orcs, deconstructing gear, destroying Uruk or Oleg followers, which will drop gear and in turn will give you Mirian, and by finding Mirian stashes throughout the game. Also keep in mind that when you set a Marauder Overlord to control a region, you gain more Mirian in general. Before moving on to the second form of currency, we'll show you what you can spend your precious Mirian on. You can upgrade your army or fortress, upgrade your gear, and buy silver microtransactions. The secondary form of currency is gold, which can be obtained by paying for it with money, completing specific milestones, and participating in community challenges. We don't know anything more about the milestones and community challenges, and hopefully we'll hear something soon about it, but we do know that it doesn't give you that much gold. You can spend your gold in the marketplace. As can be seen, there are multiple options here. All the way on the top of the list is your garrison. Here you can see how many captains, chests, and boosts you have. Below that you can see the feature chests. These will change every week on Friday and give you a certain class of enemy. If you want to know what these classes are, check out our classes video. And these will cost you 220 to 260 gold and will reward you with 3 orcs of that specific class, 1 legendary and 2 epics, and 2 consumables, which are either training orders or spoil of war boosts. Training orders can teach warchiefs or captains a new trade. Spoils of war are points that can be saved up to earn spoils of war chests, which in turn will give you loot. Moving on, we can see that there are bundles. Bundles are essentially a pack of 3 war or loot chests, which we'll get into in a second, that can be bought at a slightly lower cost. Of course, mainly meant to trick people into spending more money. Simple as that. The rewards are similar to the chests we'll show you shortly. Moving on to the war chests. These come in 3 varieties, silver, gold and mithril. The silver one costs 1000 Mirian and rewards you with 2 orc followers, from which there is at least 1 epic and 1 consumable as well. The gold war chest can be bought for 200 gold and contains 3 orc followers, 1 legendary and 2 epic, and 2 consumables. And the third and most expensive one, the mithril war chest, costs you 600 gold and contains 4 legendary orc followers and 1 legendary training order. The next category is the loot chest. These differ from the war chest as they are not rewarding you with orcs but with gear. Once again, they are categorized in silver, gold and mithril. The silver one costs 500 Mirian and rewards you with 2 pieces of gear, at least one rare. The gold one costs 150 gold and rewards you with 3 pieces of gear, including at least 1 legendary and also an XP boost. And finally, the mithril version costs 400 gold and rewards you with 4 pieces of legendary gear and 1 XP boost. The final category is called boosts. Here you can buy XP and spoils or war boosts that last up to 2 hours. We know that a lot of people are dissatisfied with the fact that these microtransactions are in a single player game. We're planning on making a video on the topic of microtransactions in Shadow of War to share our opinion on it, so we're not going to get into it this video. Even though we disagree with Monolith and Warner Brothers for adding these, all we want to say is don't let it spoil the fun. The rest of the game looks great, and it was probably not Monolith's decision but the one of Warner Brothers, so keep your head up. Anyways, we hope you at least learned something from this video. Thank you for watching, consider leaving a like if you enjoyed the video, or a dislike if you didn't. In either case, leave us some constructive feedback on the video, art style, commentary and content. In case you want to stay updated, consider subscribing and clicking the notification bell for instant pop-ups when we upload. If you have any questions, want to share your ideas, or if you simply want to start a discussion, let us know in the comment section down below. Once again, thank you for watching, and we'll hopefully see you in the next video.
Face me like a true warrior.